YouTube family, what up though? It's me, Shiz Griffin, the Griffmeister, aka your favorite YouTuber. Y'all already know what to do. Like, comment, and subscribe. So me and you together can take this worldwide. We doing something different today. I know y'all love me for trash characters, but this ain't that. But I promise, it'll still be a good video. Trust me, dog. Y'all clicked on it, so obviously this is what y'all into too. But yeah, I love music, and one of my favorite rap artists is Lil Wayne. I love hip-hop. Hip-hop, I'm a hip-hop head, and I'm gonna get into more hip-hop on this channel. Hip-hop is life. Hip-hop saved my life. Shout out Lupe Fiasco. Yeah, another great artist in the hip-hop genre. But anyway, we're gonna talk about one of the GOATs, Weezy F. Baby, the F is for phenomenal. Alright, that's not making the case. But yeah, just follow me. He had one of the best album series to date. You know, Jay-Z, he got blueprints and shit. Other motherfuckers got sequels in their arsenal. But the Carter is one of the most genre-defining series in music. Like, if we talking about hip-hop, the Carter series has to be mentioned. Like, if you introducing somebody to hip-hop and you want to talk about what hip-hop is, the Carter series has got to be mentioned. All right, maybe I'm going a little overboard with that. I don't know. But that's my personal opinion. I feel like we talking about the history of hip-hop, the Carter series and Lil Wayne story has to be mentioned. One of the best hip-hop stories of all time, in my opinion. Probably the best. Next to Jay-Z and 50 Cent. Yeah, but Wayne was the young nigga. The young squire waiting. He was in a camp of all-stars. He was in a camp called Cash Money Records, by the way. He was in a camp with Juvenile, Mr. Back That Ass Up, Manny Fresh, Mr. Boom Boom Clap, Mr. AKA, he looked like every stud in the hood. He also was in the group with an upcoming, you know, BG. You know, BG just got out. Stay out of jail too, by the way, my nigga. We needed you out here. You a legend. Turk, yeah, Cash Money, they had it all. Lil Wayne, he was just a young squire coming up. They was all heavyweights. Well, except for Turk. Nobody really. We ain't gonna get into all that, but y'all know. Niggas, maybe niggas from down south could say that they was like real Turk fans, but East Coast niggas, the niggas I named before Turk, that's what we was fucking with. BG, Juvie, Manny Fresh, Wayne, even Birdman was getting more burn than Turk. But we not gonna get into all. We not trashing Turk. This is not a Turk trashing video. This is a video about how great Wayne is. Wayne came up under them. Everybody left for money issues or whatever it was. I don't know. I ain't getting into it. That's not what this is about. But yeah, and then he carried Cash Money on his back basically when everybody left. It was just him and Uncle Bird. The Birdman. All three of y'all. Yeah, him. It was just them two left. And they put that shit on their back and they carried that motherfucker with the Carter series. But we gonna rank them. It's five Carters in the series. And we are going to rank them. Me and y'all. Well, not too much of y'all. I did the ranking myself. But y'all tell me how y'all like my ranking. This shit might make me lose some subscribers and gain some subscribers. But this is my personal opinion. So don't be coming at me with the "you crazy." Keep it cool in the comments, bro. We don't want to hear how my mother should die. I should have been a cum stain on the bed. All this other shit. Fuck y'all. I don't want to hear that bullshit today. I don't. And if I see it, I'm ignoring. I ain't going not. Because any traffic on my channel is cool, to be honest. Like, y'all gonna keep making me famous, I'm cool with that. But yeah, let's move on. We about to rank the Carter series. Coming in at number five. This about to hurt some feelings, bro. I don't give a fuck. The Carter. The first one. Yeah, it holds a special place. Because it's the one that started off people looking at Wayne and taking him serious. And, you know, there's a lot of motherfuckers out there saying that Uncle Gilly, shout out to Gilly and Wallow, $1 million worth of game is that shit. But yeah, there's a lot of motherfuckers saying Gilly wrote the Carter. Motherfuckers saying Gilly didn't write the Carter. Guess what? I don't know whether he wrote the Carter or not. But it's still a classic album. Because like it's like I said, it started out Wayne's legendary career to be like people looking at him as a GOAT. It didn't start out his career. His first album was Block Is Hot, which is also a good album too. Check that out. But yeah, the first Carter is the last one for me. Like it's number five. It don't got that much replay value today. Like it got shit like got my favorite songs on there, like Go DJ, and another song on there called Snitch that I really enjoy. It's a lot of songs on there that's still like it's still good enough, but it's like the sound that shit sounds too 2000s, if that make any sense. You know how some albums got that classic sound and then some albums is just like you could tell it was a product of the time. It's the Carter. The Carter is definitely a product of his fucking time. And that's why it's number five. And it's my least favorite. So y'all can kill me in the comments. I don't care. Moving on. Number four. What's number four? Sorry, y'all. I'm hot. But number four, Carter 5. Carter 5 was a good comeback. We waited so long for this motherfucker too. That's why it's so low. You know what I mean? Maybe if you would have came with it when we wanted it and not expecting it, maybe it would have been higher. But I'm putting it at number four. It's a really good album. It's just too long. It got a lot of songs on there I like. Like he did the Don't Cry with XXXTentacion. XXX, that nigga sounds amazing on that song. He got Mona Lisa with K-Dot, King Kunta, Kendrick. Yeah, Kendrick verse, fucking phenomenal on that. Then he got the, God damn it, what's that song? That song, the one that sampled Special Delivery. Yeah, Where the Love Go. That shit, yeah, that's my shit. I fucks with it. The album is really strong. Let It All Work Out. I fucks with the Carter 5 more than the Carter. The Carter 5 was way too overdue, but when we got it, I enjoyed it. Thank you, Wayne. I appreciate it. Yeah, that's why it's number four. But we moving on. Let's move on. This about to give me some hate. I already know. I can smell the hate coming a mile away. I can see the haters in line over there somewhere. I can see motherfuckers getting ready to throw tomatoes at me because y'all ain't getting ready like this. Old heads, y'all not getting ready like this. But the Carter 2 is number 3. And let me explain myself. Again, it's too many songs on it. It's too many. If he would have cut the album in half, Carter 2 would have no doubt been number one. Carter 2 is number one on a lot of people's list. Not mine, though. Because I went back and listened to all these albums recently. And Carter 2 is number three for me. I'm sorry. Y'all can hate me if y'all want to. I don't care. But it does have a lot of legendary Wayne tracks. We got Shooter on there featuring Robin Thicke. We got Fireman on there. Fireman, the Fireman. Yeah, that's one of my favorite Wayne songs. Matter of fact, that's an essential Wayne song. If I had to introduce somebody to Lil Wayne, that's probably the first song I would play is Fireman. Shh, the Fireman coming. Ooh, I was scared too. But look, what else on that album? Receipt. Well, he was talking about Trina and their relationship. Yeah. Money on My Mind is on that album, I believe. Birdman Jr. Well, BMJR. Yeah. Yeah. It's a lot of good cuts. Wheezy Baby. It's a lot of good cuts on this album, bro. Like, this album is really good. Hustler Music. How the fuck I forget about Hustler Music? Man, if I would have forgot that, y'all niggas would have killed me in the comments. I already know. But Hustler Music, bro. That video is so iconic and legendary. Yeah. But with all that aside, with all the good shit, There's a lot of songs on here that he could have just cut. And that's why it's number three. And it's not two or one. So if y'all gonna hate, go ahead and hate. I'm waiting for it. And fuck y'all. I don't care. Carter 2 is at number 3. I'm sorry. It is what it is, cuz. Number 2. Moving on. Number 2. I'm not hurting no more feelings. So, y'all ain't gotta kill me for this. But maybe y'all might. Because y'all still might disagree with this one being so fucking hot. But Carter 4 is better than Carter 2. Carter 5 and Carter 1. Carter 4 is so underrated. It don't make no motherfucking sense. It's so many bangers on this album. From first of all, the nigga on the outro got Nas, Bun B, The Return of Shine. Yes, Shine. And then Busta Rhymes ends the album. So iconic, so legendary. On the interlude, he got Tech N9ne and 3 Stacks. Andre 3000, bro. How the fuck we get Wayne, Tech N9ne, and Andre on the same track? That is fucking legendary, bro. Then other album, cause you got President Carter on that motherfucker, which is one of my favorite Wayne songs. I don't know why, I just like it. He be rhyming on that shit. You got lady songs on there like How to Love. She Will is on there for the clubs and the singles and shit. 6 foot, 7 foot is a Millie on steroids. Like, a Millie was great, but 6 foot seven was that times 10. With Corey Gunn's verse, oh my God, bro. That shit is godly, bro. I'm not playing none of this shit on my channel because I'm not trying to get in trouble or copyrighted or flagged or whatever you want to call it. Had that big ass circle, red circle with the line in between it on my channel. Hell no, we ain't doing that, beloved. Look, Carter 4 is so underrated, man. It's like a messy masterpiece. Yeah, it's so good. Like, Mega Man is on there. Blunt Blowing. Up and Away is on there. Like, bro, Carter 4 is so underrated because it's coming after, you know what, the Carter 3. And I think a lot of people, they gave it the massacre treatment. Oh, it wasn't Get Rich or Die Tryin', but it was still an excellent album. We're gonna talk about that too. 50 You My God, The Massacre. That's that shit. But yeah, Carter 4 came after a legendary album, which was Carter 3. So I think many people didn't care about it, or they didn't pay attention, or they was too hard on it. But bruh, when you go back and listen to the Carter 4, by the way, Carter 4 is the most replayable Carter in the series, by the way. Like, if we talking about years later, like, matter of fact, right now, the Carter 4 is still playable, and it don't sound like it came out in 2011, I believe. Yeah, Carter 4 is underrated. If you haven't listened to the Carter 4, please check out the Carter 4. Did you expect anything else to be number one? Carter 3, the nigga went a million in a week, and I was a youngin' at the time. I think I probably was like 14, maybe 15 when this shit came out. The nigga did a million in a week. He had the world in the palm of his hands. You understand what I'm saying? In the palm of his hand, bruh. Bruh, it's so many legendary songs on this album. I started with a Millie because we already talked about that. A Millie, when that shit came out, a Millie, a Millie. And then everybody, let me tell you, imagine a beat coming out or a song coming out today, and everybody rapping on this beat. When I tell you everybody rapped on this Amelie beat, that's how legendary this shit was. Mr. Carter featuring Jay-Z. Jay-Z passing the torch to Wayne. Like, here you go. Here go the throne. I'm out. This is yours now. Take over. Then we got songs like motherfucking, Let the Beat Build. Kanye on the track. Kanye on the song Comfortable. He did that beat. Babyface on the track. Wayne and Babyface. Yo, I'm telling you, that is one of the best hooks ever in hip hop. Ever. Don't you ever get too comfortable. Comfortable. One of my favorite Wayne songs. One of my favorite hip hop songs of all time. Y'all need to go check that out if y'all don't know what that is. Comfortable featuring Babyface, Lil Wayne. Yeah, he got other hits on here too. Phone Home. Well, it didn't age well. So if you a new listener, Wayne, you probably not gonna like that song. But if you a nigga that's old like me, you'll remember that and you'll fall right back in love with it. Dr. Carter was on there when he was like playing like a doctor for rappers and shit. Like, bro, Wayne was on some shit on this album. Got Money. Oh my god, I love that fucking song. Like Whoosh, like Digga 1000, like Whoosh, bro. Mac Main, his verse at the end, bro, I love that. T-Pain on that hook was crazy, bro. Carter 3 is a 5 out of 5 in my book. It's another messy masterpiece. Wayne is playing with so many styles, so many flows, so many different type of beat sounds and shit. He go New York, he go Southern. Shit, he might go Midwest, he might go West in that motherfucker. You never know. Wayne might give you a love song, he might give you a song when he's straight rapping, he might give you a song for the club, for the radios and all that shit. Bro, this album is perfect. It's so many great songs. Lollipop as a single is a smash hit, but he took over the world singing on that motherfucker. We never thought we'd get a singing Wayne track with auto-tune, but we did. And I was here for it. I didn't like it at first, but once that shit grew on me, it grew. And the remix with Ye, chef's kiss, my nigga. But yeah, that's my ranking of the Carter series. That's my humble opinion. Don't kill me in the comments. Don't try to roast me and say I look like a smoked out LeBron. Don't try to say I look like Chris Rock in 2024. Don't try to say I look like Tory Lanez or some shit. I look like Flex Alexander's flat app son and shit. Don't try to kill me in the comments. Please be nice. Don't say my mother shouldn't have had me. Don't say I should have been left as a cum stain in the hotel bedroom. That's not nice. Your parents raised you better than that. And if they didn't, that's fucked up too. But yeah, listen. That's it, man. I'm out. Peace.